Welcome to Napa Valley, the top-rated wine tasting destination in the U.S. It's just an hour outside of San Francisco and is the perfect getaway for just plain chillaxing. This weekend, I'm going to introduce to you some of the top destination wineries. Every year, over 4 million people converge on Napa, both locals and out-of-towners. The number of wineries has also expanded exponentially, and at last count, there were almost 500. This makes it kind of difficult to figure out which wineries to put onto your itinerary. So here's my advice. First of all, only plan between 2 to 3 wineries a day. This is not a race. Plan for 2 if you're going at a more leisurely pace. Second, group your wineries by town. Napa and Sonoma counties are huge, and it could take you an hour to drive between wineries. Why spend an hour driving if you could use it drinking wine? Third, decide if you're going for the best wines or the best destinations. Some of the best destinations don't necessarily have the best wines and vice versa. In fact, some of the best wines are produced by small wineries in very humble wine tasting rooms. This weekend, we are going for the best destinations where you're going to get the most bang for your wine tasting experience. Fourth, Napa wine tastings are really expensive. Count anywhere from between $30 to $65 for just a bar tasting. And if you're looking to go on a cave tour or a food pairing, it costs even more. If you want free tastings, look at Sonoma. Finally, because Napa is so popular, many of the wine tastings are by appointment only. So make sure that you book in advance. You could try to show up at the day of, but don't count on being able to get in.
This weekend, we're focusing on the St. Helena, Calistoga region with its famous hot springs and mud baths. The spectacular property is Del Dotto Estates Winery and Caves. It's one of 4 Northern California wineries owned and run by Dave and Yolando Del Dotto. Their vineyards reflect Dave's Venetian heritage and his prior life as a real estate developer. No expense was spared in creating this lavish Venetian villa. When you first roll up, the beautiful travertine marble entry facade looks quite modest, and you think, that's it? Actually, the facility is huge and built underground with tasting rooms, production areas, aging cellars, and kitchens. I wasn't able to film inside the caves and production area, but it's just as lavishly decorated as the tasting rooms. The intricate marble tile floors and cave brickwork were all hand-laid by imported Italian artisans. Not one area is alike. The walls and ceiling are decorated with painted frescoes in the Renaissance tradition, and giant Murano glass chandeliers light the way, even down in the caves. The recommended experience here is to take the cave tour. This is a cave tour like no other and not one to be missed. This guided tour not only takes you through the caves, but also includes an extended educational tasting right from the casks. You can experience firsthand how the casking process affects the wine. The tour wraps back in the tasting room where you'll get to sample the finished aged products and compare it to the raw tannic flavors of the cask wines. This is one of the few destinations where the wines are outstanding. Winemaking experimentation and creativity is high with well over 35 different cab styles alone. Wines are paired with house-made salumi and pizzas, as well as various cheeses and chocolates.
Del Dotto is known for its big, bold wines, especially the Cabernet Sauvignons. And because it is still a small production winery, you can really only purchase the bottles right here.
The wines are fairly pricey, so yeah, I only bought one bottle. 300 feet above Calistoga is Sterling Vineyards. The theme is Mediterranean, starting with a long drive down an olive tree-lined road. Then take the only solar-powered aerial tram in Napa up to the winery. Founded in 1964 by Englishman Peter Newton, the buildings are a whitewashed stucco reminiscent of Mykonos Greek islands where he did a stint. It's now owned by Treasury Wine Estates, who expanded the visitor center perfectly for tourism. You could go at your own pace, which I loved, and there's no pushy salesman tactics.
Sterling has more of a kickback feel to it, and it's a self-guided tour. Once you get off the aerial tram, you first come to the first bar where you'll pick up your souvenir glass and your first sip of wine.
No matter where you are, spectacular 360-degree views of Northern Napa Valley lay below you. Rounding the corner, you'll get a full glimpse of the building and its 2 bell towers. The bells were cast in the early 1700s and used to hang in London's Church of St. Dunstan's in the east. They toll every 15 minutes, and it's well worth it to hang back a bit and wait for the show. Onwards, there are more pouring stations in each production room.
This is the sorting station where they sort all of the grapes. This is super cool. This is their crush pad area back here where they crush the grapes and they get fermented in these giant tanks over here. This is the room where they're fermenting the reserved wines, and you've got some oak barrels, concrete barrels over here. Quick view of the wood casks where the wine is stored and aged.
And stop to chat with the friendly wine pourers along the way. You'll learn a lot about equipment and winemaking. Sterling is one of the largest well-known Napa wineries, producing a huge variety of award-winning wines typically priced in the mid to high range, although they are best known for Merlots and Cabs.
The tour ends here at their patio with a spectacular view overlooking Diamond Mountain.
There's patio seating to park your butt for a while. If you're hungry, they sell food pairings. Or take a stroll around the outside railing and take in the gorgeous scenery. See that castle out there? What say we wander over there next?
Our next stop is at Castello di Amorosa, a 136,000 square foot, 13th century Tuscan castle that was recreated by Dario Satui over 14 years.
The Castle of Love is like Disneyland or Venice. Touristy, crowded, but so outrageously over the top, you have to experience it at least once. Fascinated by medieval architecture, Dario decided to make it truly authentic with authentic antique materials from Europe and authentic building methods. Although there is a self-guided tour with a basic tasting fee that covers the main floor and upper towers, I recommend purchasing the guided tour, which takes you down to the lower floors and caves. They are a small production winery relying on tours and direct sales, so it feels a bit more salesy. Just don't let that annoy you. There is a moat and a working drawbridge with the windlass in the gatehouse above, animal pens with live pigs, chickens and amazingly shrill peacocks, and lots of sheep. There's a family chapel for daily worship, towers and battlements with sweeping views, a central courtyard that was featured in the 14th season of The Bachelor, and a great hall with an original Italian fireplace and movie furniture left over from filming Disney's bedtime stories. Let's head down to the caves for the good stuff. There's an armory with antique suits of armor and weapons, a torture chamber featuring an Iron Maiden and a spiked Judas chair. You're also treated to a barrel tasting. The tour ends with more wine tasting of their bold reds and whites. The wines are drinkable, but if you have a more refined palate, pony up the extra money for the reserve tasting and stick to the higher end stuff.
In total, give yourself between 3 to 4 hours for this winery. A little over 2 hours for the tour and wine tasting, and then maybe 30 to 45 minutes to shop and purchase items from the gift shop. And then give yourself 30 to 45 again for just looking around the outside of the property, the beautiful landscaping, and also the farm animals that they have housed around here. Thanks for coming along today and drinking with me. Don't forget to give yourself an hour or two before you hit the roads. We've only covered a small number of destination wineries here in the St. Helena, Calistoga region, but Napa has so much more to offer and see. Look for some additional videos coming up on different areas of Napa, including the Silverado Trail and Yountville area. Until next time, peace out.